Hello, Tim Nufire here. I'm really excited to show you the new design. This is Storage Pod 4.0. We are really excited to bring a number of great advances and improvements in this rev of the hardware. What is most interesting about this design is we've gotten rid of the 9 backplanes that used to be in the front section here. Those backplanes, among other things, were just hard to get. They were a special kind of one-off component. They came from a manufacturer in Taiwan. We certainly had concerns just around the single source nature. The other thing was that they were a port multiplier technology that had to be paired in the front end with compatible cards on the motherboard side of the fence. With this design, we've got 45 independent drives that simply come into the motherboard section as individual channels. How we produce 45 signals, now that's the challenge. It's obviously easy to get something in the order of 5 or 6 SATA cables directly off a motherboard. Getting enough kind of SATA connections out from the motherboard into 45 drives, there's your challenge. The good news is, as the market's evolved, there are now cards like the Rocket Rate, so the Rocket Rate 750. It's an incredibly nice card. It is 40 ports. We got 45 drives, so the current architecture actually uses 2 of these, giving us a total of 80 ports, of which only 45 are being used. The underlying technology in these Rocket Rate cards is actually similar to what we had before, in that they've simply taken what we used to have as port multiplier technology, where we had one SATA channel going into a single backplane with 5 drives. They now do the port multiplier architecture on the card itself. So the card has 8 SATA channels coming in, going into 8 PCIe lanes. Those then go into 8 port multipliers out to the 40 ports. Those then go out to the front of the chassis through these connectors. This is a standard mini SAS connector. There's lots of cards you can get that would support this architecture. So by switching to this design, we're actually somewhat independent of the card that you place on this side of the chassis. Again, we're very happy with this card kind of out of the gate. On this side, so you're connecting mini SAS into one of these cards. On this side, you then have, you can see kind of a fan cable. Each one of the mini SAS is really 4 discrete SATA channels, no logical multiplexing. It's literally just that many wires inside one bundled cable. Drives also need power, so this has 2 Molex connectors attaching to it, which then you feed off of the power supply. So if you can see here in the chassis, you've got the cables all kind of bolted down to the metal grids. The Molex connectors are then connected off of leads off the power supply. Other changes in this chassis are we've gone down to a single power supply. That was done mostly for cost reasons. A single unit is cheaper than dual units. We're getting dramatically better performance. Now, Backblaze, as a kind of online storage archive backup company, speed at some level has never been our priority. We're looking for reliability, we're looking for cost. But from an operational standpoint, you do have to sync the RAID arrays and do other operational tasks where performance does matter. These are something in the order of 4 to 5 times faster than the old architecture. It's a dramatic change, specifically removing bottlenecks on the motherboard. Having only 3 lanes into the motherboard was a performance bottleneck. We'd see faster performance. If we'd sync 1 RAID array, it was 3 times faster than if we sync 3. We were clearly bottlenecked on the kind of I/O bandwidth going straight into the motherboard. Each one of these cards is 8 lanes. So we got a total of 16 lanes into the motherboard, where we used to have 3 lanes into the motherboard. This architecture is all fully SATA 3 as well. So you got a full 6 gigabits coming out to the drives versus 3 gigabits in the old architecture. So to sum up, this design is lower cost. It is higher performance, which is dramatic from a operation standpoint, and easier to work with. Sliding rails and other components make this an operations person's dream.